Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. With this video, we are going to see the electronic admittance with respect to the reflex klystron. Earlier, to the popular device reflex klystron as oscillator, we are covered with the two cavity klystron as amplifier. Multi-cavity klystron giving more efficiency and more gain again for the amplification. So in the previous video, we have been formulating the output power and efficiency with respect to the current device we are discussing, reflex klystron. So let us see what exactly the electronic admittance is. For the reflex klystron, in the previous two videos, we have understood the working operation. The velocity modulation is again the principle of operation. With the help of Applegate diagram, the bunching process, the electron bunches formed as the electrons have been repelled because of the repeller electron that we have seen, and they are giving up the energy to the grids of the resonant cavity, that is anode cavity there, at the phase when it is retarding. So for this reflex klystron, the current produced because of these electron bunches, that we can write into the phasor form. So very first of all, we shall be mentioning the induced current into the cavity in phasor form. It will be given by the equation. We denote I2 is equal to twice capital I0 beta suffix I into J1 of capital X dash in multiplication to e to the power minus j theta 0 dash. So I0 is the beam current only because of the DC potential applied. Beta suffix I is the beam coupling coefficient with respect to the cavity. This is the Bessel's function for the first order dependent on to the buncher parameter. And for the phasor form, we have introduced this exponent e to the power minus j theta 0 dash. The theta 0 dash, that is the DC transit angle we have introduced in the previous videos. Now, as we can formulate this induced current, similarly, we can also have formulation with respect to the induced voltage. So here, the induced voltage for the output cavity, we denote by V suffix 2, and it will be given as V1 into e to the power minus j pi by 2. Let this equation can be equation number 2. So equation 1 for the induced current and equation 2 for the induced voltage, that 2 into the phasor form. This is for the retarding phase of the cavity here. So we can use both of them, the current and the voltage, so that the admittance can be computed. So now the ratio of I2 with respect to the V2, here we obtain the electronic admittance. And the electronic admittance, Y for the admittance and E as a suffix for denoting the electronic type, it is computed. Here we obtain from the first two equations, that is I0 upon capital V0 in multiplication to beta I, that is squared beam coupling coefficient, along with the theta 0 dash divided by 2. Here we have twice J1 of X dash, the Bessel's function with respect to the bunching parameter, divided by the bunching parameter X dash into the phasor form exponent. Here we have e to the power j in the bracket, we have pi by 2 minus theta 0 dash here. So I outline this particular equation, that is very important. This equation actually gives you the information of the topic title, what exactly it is. So I name it equation number 3. Now if you see the relation of electronic admittance represented by Y suffix E on the left hand side with respect to the J1 of X dash, the Bessel's function, and the X dash, the bunching parameter, you will come to know that the electronic admittance is having a non-linear nature. Here we find that the electronic admittance y suffix e is directly proportional to this numerator, and it is inversely proportional to x dash, which is directly proportional to that of the signal voltage. Now, the equivalent circuitry with respect to the reflex klystron can be given here. The circuit diagram I can draw here. So, this circuit diagram involves the three conductances. So, here at the end, I denote G suffix L. This is for the load conductance, and here we have GB representing the beam conductance. The another conductance is there that can be denoted GC, that account for the copper losses of the cavity, and we have the lumped parameters, the capacitance C here, and the inductance denoted by capital L. With respect to the negative type of current, as we have gone through the two cavity klystron amplifier, the direction of current is reverse. Hence, I mention here minus beta suffix I into I2 in this direction. Beta suffix I for the beam coupling coefficient. And the output voltage applied across this circuitry can be denoted by V2 here. So, for the equivalent circuitry shown into the diagram, here the total conductance can be denoted by capital G, and it will be simply the addition of GC to that of the GB and the GL here. So, the account of copper losses by the cavity walls denoted as the conductance GC, the beam conductance GB, and the load conductance GL are added to get G here. So, this can also be mentioned as G is equal to this particular addition, or 1 upon RSH, where RSH is the shunt resistance of the equivalent circuitry here. Now, to look at the equation number 3, where we have formulated the electronic admittance, the condition for reflex klystron to oscillate can be given as such. We have mod of minus G suffix E greater than or equal to capital G. So, capital G accounts for the total conductance that just now we have shown in the previous equation. And here, this left hand side accounts for the negative real part of the electronic admittance shown into the equation number 3. So, for electronic, we have applied the suffix small e to this conductance. So, this condition is very, very essential as far as the oscillations with respect to reflex klystron are necessary. Now, the electronic admittance that we denoted y suffix e can be denoted from the above condition in the form. Here we have g suffix e added with j times b suffix e here. So, b suffix e will be the phase constant with respect to the electron beam, and g suffix e from the above condition here. Since the electronic admittance is shown in the phasor form in the equation number 3, the value of phase for theta 0 dash will be equal to pi by 2. Now, in the rectangular plot, the electronic admittance can be shown with the help of a spiral. So, in this diagram, you can see the horizontal axis that ranges for the values of the conductance shown here, minus G suffix E up to plus G suffix E on this particular side. So, here we have the negative values, minus 20, minus 40, minus 60, minus 80, whereas plus 20, plus 40, plus 60, plus 80 with respect to the N values for the reflex klystron operation. With respect to the transit cycles, you can note. So, here we have n is equal to 1/4, n is equal to 1 1/4, n is equal to 2 times 1/4 here, and the same into the negative side also. The vertical line shows us the imaginary line for J times B here. Now here we have the dashed line that marks for minus J minus JB here. So here any value of theta 0 dash that ranges onto the left hand side of this dashed line will create the oscillations for the reflex klystron, whereas if it lies onto the right hand side for this dashed line, there it will be no oscillations, hence the marking of non-oscillation region for the reflex klystron it is. Therefore, the theta 0 dash can be expressed. Earlier also we have shown theta 0 dash will be equal to small n minus 1 by 4 times 2 pi here. It is simply capital N is equal to 2 pi here. So here capital N denotes the mode number for oscillation into the reflex klystron. So here we are covered with the understanding of the very popular oscillator into the microwave linear beam tubes, that is the reflex klystron. By the next lecture, we shall be starting practicing problems onto it. So it will be the problem number 1, reflex klystron. I hope you are getting the details of the microwave engineering with the very much benefits, and will definitely practice the problems onto it. For more information like this, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.